Good day. Okay, so I am eating very clean because just like the rest of y'all, I'm sure, you know, I overate during Christmas. And so you pull back for a few days and eat real clean and maybe lose a couple of pounds because, you know what, we've got another eating day coming up, which is New Year's. And so, you know, I'll do like a little New Year's special and we'll do some black eyed peas and cook some green cabbage and, you know, do the good luck food. But I've been craving Chinese Peking duck. So I'm probably going to, and there goes my lights. Don't know what happened there. Oh, man. Let's see. Uh-oh. Hold on. All right, we're back. Definitely not a cameraman. Okay, so back to eating clean because, you know, I always eat clean, but, you know, around the holidays, I'm not gonna sit there and do that to myself. Like, you know, Thanksgiving and Christmas, I'm gonna eat and I'm not gonna think about pulling back. I'm not gonna think about, you know, the healthier version. I'm just gonna go all out. Anyway, so, you know, you gotta pull back a couple days after that. I really wanna do the Peking duck, you know? Oh, man, you know, it's a whole process. You know, I looked it up, the recipe, maybe I can make some Peking duck here. Oh no. It's like a special kind of duck, and then they marinate it for like a long time, and you know, it's like all super special, which makes it worth it. So we're gonna go down to Peking Cuisine, which is, I think, my personal favorite Chinese place here in Houston. Of course, I never eat out, so what do I know? but anyway, it's really good, and they make the best. Oh wait, Koopy, you have pants on? Hold on. Okay. So, anyway, eating clean so we can eat duck on New Year's. And of course I'm gonna do the traditional, you know, black eyed peas and cabbage and stuff. But anyway, today I'm making I made some spinach. Spinach is really, I buy it in the big bag at Costco. Huge, right? And then, you know what? Spinach is one of those things, people, that y'all need to be eating every day. I know that's crazy, but if you throw it in a smoothie or, you know, cook it or make a salad, it is one of those things that you need to somehow get inside your body every day, like blueberries. Gotta get it in. I got a nutritionist. So, you know, this is what I've been told. So stay young, stay healthy, take care of yourselves, eat your spinach. So anyway, to cook spinach is very easy. You just put a little olive oil in a pan, you wilt it down with a little salt and pepper, and you cover it so that it shrinks down, and then just squeeze a little, shave some garlic in at the last, you know, minute. You don't want to burn the garlic. And then squeeze a little lemon juice on top. Maybe an extra little, taste it and see if it needs a little extra salt. But ignore Goopy. Anyway, that's it. The other thing, okay, so here's my spinach. And that's done. The other thing I made is some asparagus. Super simple, same way. Just take a little olive oil and heat it up in the pan. I like my things crunchy. I do not like soggy, mushy vegetables. So, doesn't take long. A little salt and pepper. It's perfect. I have some Chilean sea bass from Costco. I'm gonna pan fry that. And I'm also roasting some cauliflower to do some mashed cauliflower. And then, Mississippi Man! I got some tomatoes that I've seared. Cooper? Needs a band-aid, hold on. No blood, but still needs the band-aid. Okay, look, roasted that. You can also boil it, steam it, whatever you wanna do. I like things roasted, I think they taste better. All right, I'm gonna put this in the food processor and I'm gonna add a little melted butter. And I'm using a little coconut milk. If you're doing keto, use the heavy cream. Okay. Okie doke. So, mashed cauliflower. You know, it's not exactly the same as mashed potatoes, of course not, people. But you know what? If you're eating healthy, it's absolutely delicious. But don't walk into the sink and it's gonna be just like mashed potatoes. It's not. It's a little grainier. It's absolutely delicious, though. Add a little extra butter. I have some chives from my garden that I grow. Yeah. Science. Yeah. Restrictions apply. Visit AT&T.com. All right. So. And then, little pepper. So, see? Taste it. Mashed cauliflower. Oh, that's so good. That's so good for you. Yum. All right. So, that's done. Let's see. I got my Chilean sea bass. I'm gonna open this up and I'll be right back. This is, I'm gonna tell you, the Chilean sea bass is delicious. It already has that real buttery, you know, taste. So, it's good. Don't need to do anything to it, really. You know, you don't put it in the oven, a little salt, pepper, and oil. I like everything seared a little. I'm eating that's part of the cauliflower that most people throw out. I like it. Anyway, so I'm just gonna sear mine up with a little olive oil and a little butter mix with a little salt and pepper. Okay, beautiful. Be right back. Okay, hey, this is interesting. So I opened up my Chilean sea bass and it smells, it's got a smell to it. Look, people, don't eat it. Do not do that. Do not do that to yourself. If it does not smell right, that shit goes back. Like, I'm going to Costco. So, yeah, because $20 is $20, right? And they're real good about that. But do not eat it. Just opened and I just bought it a couple days ago, so it shouldn't be like that. It smelled like, I don't know, like a chemical smell. It was bad. All right, so backup plan. Let's see what to do. I have a little bit of crab left. How about I just pan fry a little bit of crab and to eat with all my beautiful vegetables. So I'll be right back.